And I'm back.
Wait, I'll have a look over there.
I wonder what the detection range is.
You're quite close now. I can't remember any other visitor getting so far. Do you feel pride? Anticipation? It seems you found my bedroom, though I confess sleep usually eludes me. My mind won't stop turning.
What a reward. Additionally, my efforts to fine-tune the electroshock machine have been less than successful. Breaking down the more bothersome elements of a subject's personality, such as willpower, while leaving cognition and creativity unharmed, has proven unrealistic. Instead, my machine leaves the subject babbling like a child, which is the opposite of what I need from Sokolov.
What cruelty is this?
Jindos created an electroshock machine which degrades memory and cognitive function. Located somewhere in his lab.
This machine, maybe you won't have to die after all, Jindosh.
So, the alternative, find the electroshock machine and render him unconscious for the non-lethal approach. Conditioning. He's a stubborn old goat. There's a letter here. Pause to read.
Ramsay and the Crown Killer were just the start. I need to break down Delilah's remaining allies. Jindosh, the Duke, all of them. Duke Luca Abel.
1847. Yeah, that's something. There's a whale of real size. Private, one is guest area, and number one is the assessment chamber. So I'll make a decision here. Go to eliminate Kieran first, and then try to rescue Anton. So they all activate. That's the lever in here.
Playback for detection registered.
Brianna Ashworth.
Oh, dear. Bro.
So many events in motion, each exerting subtle gravity. With Delilah, a new empire could be drawn, and all the old barriers broken. Much could be accomplished. My clockwork soldiers have played their part, but each costs more coin than a wealthy man sees in a lifetime. It could take years to find a solution on my own. But if Sokolov can be tamed, together we might refine the process, making new clockworks at a fraction of the cost. Whether I seduce my old teacher with the thrill of discovery, or whether I'm forced to apply the clamps to his flesh and turn on the voltage, no matter.
Let's pick him here. Laboratory is 38 meters away. And the door opens. The 16th day, month of rain, 1849. Journey to the Pandizian Continent by Anton Sokolov, Chapter 14. We were only miles from shore, but our approach was marred by numerous hidden reefs and jagged rocks. They lay shallow, and we spied two vessels that had come to them some time ago. The remaining crew was uncharacteristically silent as we edged by the weathered wrecks. The first mate declared a particularly narrow channel to be impassable, but the captain dispatched 10 crewmen onto the submerged coral with sledgehammers. Thereafter, each chest deep in water, they pulled the Antonio Aquilo into the tiny channel with ropes. It proved a marvelous solution. I recognize this. I've read this one before. I'll finish better. Honestly, I bear no ill will towards Emily Kelvin or her father, the royal protector. I've never given a single fig for any of those palace-born nobles in Dublin. So how could I think ill of one empress or another? He would not be incorrect in suggesting that my motivations for assisting the Duke were at least twofold. I wanted to advance the causes of natural philosophy for the sake of the work itself, and to show those stodgy morons at the Academy the light that they very nearly extinguished. Further, of course, I'm no stranger to infamy, and in fact, I'm unfortunate. Laboratory, getting closer.
At last, Imperial Majesty, you found me. You realize you're only the second person to set foot in this room, the most sophisticated laboratory in the Isles. Please, try not to damage anything as you die. Clockwork soldiers, dispatch this intruder!
Wait a minute. Soldiers.
I wonder who will live here in this place after I've passed from the world. How long will the intricate parts continue to function? Enough of this. Come out and face me.
I can always pull the lever if I get into difficulties.
Playback indicates some detection without certainty.
They're up there.
Ready now. Remove this playback after the final field test.
He's up there. Oh, he's up there. Yep.
The machine is running at low speed.
What is it that motivates you?
So I've got to deal with the damn soldiers.
Perhaps it is something I cannot measure, but I will try.
I'll be right back.
Blaze. Check central rotor. Still idling. Take this opportunity to back charge second coil.
What can I use against them? Machines, aren't they? They're robots, so you should be able to take them out.
Kieran Jindosh.
You don't stand a chance anyway.
Kieran, it's my hope that the Pale Star has looked down with favor upon your attempts to gain Sokolov's favor. But if the old goat will not bend to your will, I can offer an alternative to merely keeping him locked in your assessment chamber and subjecting him to cruel electrotherapy. Conditioning him. nice person. Well, I think we need to use the electroshock machine on you. Reflection on my journey, chapter 60. Pause to read. I think I've read that one before too. Note to self, there is insufficient power to operate the electroshock machine. Until this is rectified, I will have to compensate, freeing up more power for the electroshock machine by configuring the other laboratory platforms so they draw the least power.
The other lab machines are draining away too much electricity.
Okay. Well, I'll take a break and mull over this over my coffee. Thanks for watching. See you in the next part. Thank you.